We believe our economy can't afford to waste a single pair of capable hands.
The tough love budget, billions slashed to get back in the black.
It cuts $2 billion out of payments to families at a time when they really need the money. I mean, I'm just astounded.
Good evening, I'm Sandra Sully. This is a special federal budget edition of 10's Late News. Wayne Swan has delivered the first budget in 9 years not to contain any personal tax cuts. Instead, the Treasurer has cut $22 billion, including family payments, to keep the budget on track for a return to surplus in 2 years.
His budget bottom line's been ravaged by the hangover of the global financial crisis and natural disasters, but the Treasurer went on the front foot.
This Labor budget is to put the opportunities that flow from a strong economy within the reach of more Australians.
There's a $3 billion training package which includes $500 million for 130,000 industry-based places, $200 million to fast-track apprentices and $1.75 billion for national reform of vocational training. And the expectation is that the long-term unemployed, many on disability pensions and teenagers more inclined to avoid work, will participate. Tougher work tests will apply, the withdrawal of benefits the ultimate sanction.
Some people will get a bit of a nudge.
There's $22 billion in cuts to get the budget back into surplus in 2 years, including a $2 billion hit to family payments by pausing indexation, and $755 million by scrapping the dependent spouse rebate for single partners under 40.
We had a choice between meandering back to surplus at a slower rate and doing it later, or doing the right thing and coming up with tough saves.
This year's deficit has blown out to almost $50 billion, halving next year before returning to a modest surplus in 2 years.
Mr Speaker, tonight I'm particularly proud to announce new improvements to mental health services.
Yeah. There's a $2.2 billion package, $1.5 billion new money, meeting the government's priority commitment. And there's also $1.8 billion for regional hospital upgrades. The Treasurer made room for it by nipping and tucking elsewhere. Changes to fringe benefits on cars saves another $1 billion. Defence comes to the aid of the nation with $2.7 billion, thanks to efficiencies and delaying big purchases. The public service plays its part with $1 billion from the efficiency dividend.
I don't take any joy in some of the measures we have put in place in this budget.
Some big spending can't be dodged. Border protection has a $3.3 billion price tag. The Malaysian solution, $292 million. Defence all up, $21.3 billion. Wayne Swan says his fourth budget is not about causing pain, but getting the settings right.
Well, it's jobs, jobs and jobs.
The budget forecasts 500,000 new jobs in the next 2 years, with unemployment falling to 4.5%. The economy will roar back to 4% growth next year, falling to 3.75% in 2013. Inflation will fall to 2.75% next year, but hit 3% the following year, adding to pressure on interest rates. This is the first budget in 9 years that isn't offering any personal income tax cuts. In fact, the Treasurer is asking middle and higher income earners to pay more tax, at least until the next election. But the Treasurer says average income earners, thanks to his previous tax cuts, are $1,000 a year better off. And the elephant in the room did get a mention.
Our industries must transition to the clean energy technologies of the future, encouraged by a price on carbon.
That's a fight for another day. The boss, meantime, thinks it's a job well done. Paul Bongiorno, 10 News.